Favorite drink. France is famous for its wine, its beer in Germany. Turkey has its coffee, and they serve it blacker than ink. Russians go for vodka, and England loves its tea. Oh, the factories may be roaring with the boom-a-lacka, zoom-a-lacka wee, but there isn't any roar when the clock strikes four. Everything stops for tea. Oh, a lawyer in a courtroom, in the middle of an alimony plea, has to stop and help him pour when the clock strikes four. Everything stops for tea. It's a very good English custom, though the weather be cold or hot. When you need a little pickup, you'll find a little teacup will always hit the spot. You remember Cleopatra had a date to meet Mark Antony at three. When it came an hour late, she said, you'll have to wait, but everything's up for tea. Oh, they may be playing football, and the crowd is yelling, kill the referee. But no matter what the score, when the clock strikes four, everything's up for tea. Oh, the golfer may be golfing, and is just about to make a hole in three. But it always gets them sore when the clock yells four, everything's up for tea. It's a very good English custom and a stimulant for the brain. When you feel a little weary, a cup will make you cheery, and it's cheaper than champagne. Now I know just why Franz Schubert didn't finish his unfinished symphony. He might have written more, but the clock struck four, and everything's done for tea.
One loves impulsive creatures who do before they think. There are other sadder features to this rather dangerous kink, for although they gain much pleasure, prompt a satisfying taste, they must repent at leisure the achievements of their haste. A momentary loss of self-control is very wrong. One finds out before long it's considerably wiser on the whole to be strong, very strong. A man proposed one evening, when rather full of bass. He'd meant to stay a bachelor, the man was just an ass. For he said when someone asked him why he had to wed the lass,
a momentary loss of self-control.
When the weary day is nearly over, stars begin to creep into the sky. That's the time all of us will forget the other. In the lengthening shadows, you and I. Moonshine is better than sunshine. It's always the right time when you are in love. Nighttime is better than daytime. It's always the gay time when you are in love.
Everybody's walking round just like a lot of chumps. They're moaning and groaning and right down in the dumps. Every time they meet, they tell each other things are bad, instead of saying something that will make each other glad. Ta-da, be lucky, that's the thing to say. Ta-da, be lucky when friends are going away. Wish them health and happiness as you stand at the door. Wish them all you wish yourself, and don't forget to roar. Ta-da! Be lucky, that's the thing to say. It sends them on their journey bright and gay. Wave your hand and say goodbye. Wear a cheery smile and cry, ta-da! Be lucky, ta-da! Be lucky today.
Now I went to a lecture, and there was a great commotion. The speaker said, I've traveled all the land and all the ocean. I talk all foreign languages, I've been in every clime. I know all ancient history, and I'm learning all the time. A married man down in the second row said, mister, here's one thing you'll never know. Why, you can't understand the lady. You can't understand the girl. You may have been to college where they cram things into you. You'll never know the reason ladies do the things they do. You'll admit they're funny creatures with lovely features, so sweet and small. I know a girl who trains a lot of savage grizzly bears. She'll put her head into a lion's mouth and never cares. But if she should see a mouse, she'd go and scream all around the house. Why, you can't understand them at all.
Not a place in all the land like the good old Tower of London, where everything is awfully grand in the glorious Tower of London. For the walls are high and the dungeons deep. Refreshments there are very, very cheap. But the beer it is not warranted to keep in the good old Tower of London. There's no place on the face of the earth like the Tower of London. If you've never been there, go again. It's a glorious place. Everything old. Now, in the first place, when you visit the Tower of London, it's free. But you have to pay a shilling to go in. And the first ancient item you see is the man that takes the money at the door.
My mother says when first I wore a long black skirt and blouses, to always keep my eye on any thing that's wearing trousers. They're always running after cheeky little girls like me. But if one starts to chase the eye, shall show my dignity. For my mother said, always look under the bed before you blow the candle out. See if there's a man about. I always do. You can make a bet, but it's never been my luck to find a man there yet.
It was a joint affair, they both got in the stew. He tried to cut her, but he found it wouldn't do. He was a blade, but she was on her mettle too. At the spooning of the knife and fork, she fell for him because he looked so sharp and strong. He liked her curves, and though his thoughts were very wrong, declared that she had sex appeal in every prong. 'Twas the spooning of the knife and fork.
The truth about the matter was published by the Flatter. Then everybody knew it, and the condiments assembled for a gossip in the cruet.
I fear the rest is rather gloomy to relate. They scraped acquaintance up but had to separate with just a cuddle on the pattern of the plate.
That's the spooning of the knife and fork.
That's the second pair of stockings I've knitted tonight waiting for my daughter to come home. As it takes me 3 hours to knit one pair of stockings with my eyes shut, it must be getting late. I wonder where she is. I wonder where she's gone. I wonder who she's with. I wonder what she's doing. I wonder what time it is. I hope she's all right. Oh, mothers, mothers with daughters, it's only you that knows the anxiety of a mother. Oh, I beseech you, I implore you, watch your daughters. Keep them home and keep them down, because you never know. Be warned, beware, be everywhere. Otherwise, 48 hours leave and Bob's your uncle.
Hello, mother, I'm home.
And yet I'm...
would reside in fancy little houses and be dressed in shoes and hats and trousers. In a world of my own, all the flowers would have very extra special powers. They would sit and talk to me for hours when I'm lonely in a world of my own. There'd be new birds, lots of nice and friendly howdy-do birds. Everyone would have a dozen bluebirds. Within that world of my own, I could listen to a babbling brook and hear a song that I could understand. I keep wishing it could be that way, because my world would be a
thank you. Thank you. Well, hello, Belgium. You're a bunch of screamers out there, and you know that I love that. You dirty, 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 dirty girls and boys. So I see a lot of my Belgian beauties here that actually got the plague for me last time and came back again, and that is very, very, very good. And I also heard that we have some beautiful ladies from the Netherlands here as well. So you know what that means for me? It's like a candy shop of beautiful, beautiful muffins. Because you know, I love my girls. And you know, oh, I love you. You don't even understand. I'm recording this later, and I'm gonna play back your screams in the tour bus tonight.
I want to see your pain. Are you suffering? I want to suffer. I want to see your pain. Are you suffering? I want to suffer. I want to see your pain. 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 I want to see your p walls, from street homes to ladies of good breeding.
Inbreeding!
I'd like to introduce you.
This is how it works.
Paris Court. So sad. All right, that's how you know it's live, bitches. So, Paris Court, you sing just for us. Just me, just you. Nobody can hear you, no critique, no record, just practice. The second verse, however, is for something entirely different. But we'll talk about that when the time comes. So are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you really ready?
Yeah.
All right. I can count to four, single digits only, that is the extent of my mathematical knowledge. One, two, three, four. She looked up at the spinning wheel, she can't recall what it was like. She said, this room's gonna be my grave, there's no one who can save me. She sits down to a blood and red, she knows, but it's waiting up in their bed. She said, how long can I live this way, is there no one I can save?
I'm gonna die in the tears. for a small cup of tea and a biscuit. And you two have your whore femmes out. Were you doing the sideways clamshell again?
No.
You were. I know you were. Well, it was awful. Veronica?
Yes.
Did you lick anybody?
Not in the last 5 minutes.
Wait just a minute. That means that at some point during shallot. Oh. Aprella?
Yes.
What were you doing?
Teaching ballet class.
Were you being destructive? Were you distracting them?
No.
Were they bothering you?
No!
Oh, stop. You don't have to say that just because Veronica. Aprella?
Yeah.
What were you really doing?
Plié? Grand plié?
She's lying, isn't she?
No!
Aprella doesn't lie.
I know. Stop crying! Oh, shut up. It's reverse psychology. I yell at her first, then she cries and gets it all out. But you. Perverse psychology. Eat a bathroom broke.
It's getting so hot.
Did you happen to notice that during Shallot, that sweet, pretty, gentle little song about happiness, that my voice was going just a slight bit hoarse? Well, it was. Do you know why that is? Because I had to yell at Auntie Veronica all morning long. It's not my play, that's why.
Because I made out with Contessa.
Mm. Oh, is that all? I made out with Capella. That's disgusting.
It's not.
What else? Just spill it. What else?
Captain Maggie gave me a bunch of funny tasting tea and then I made out with her.
All that time, you should have been doing what?
Making out with you.
Oh, yeah!
No comment. Did Captain Mavis make the tea today? He didn't. That means there's not a drop of tea in this.
Yes!
And it is so good. Maybe you'll get some later. Contessa, I have a job for you. You're really scaring me right now. Stop looking at me with those religious Christ-like eyes. Blasphemous. Listen to me. Today's your lucky day. Today's the day I'm going to officially ask you to call upon one of your higher powers. Because quite frankly, I'm at my wit's end in more ways than one, and I cannot deal with that shit anymore. Your sexuality is distracting me. Can't work like this. I feel that today, with you all and your help and your hands together, that perhaps we can pray for the saving, the maintenance, the protection of Veronica's chastity. It is a grave danger. Contessa, take it away.
Please, everybody. Please put your fingers together. Please repeat after me the divine next repetition.
Captain Maggot, set an example. Drunkenness is no excuse not to pray.
Dear divine above the great soul of our muffins. Every one piece of their clothes.
Leave us all remember
that you're moving close. And dear to my bow.
And dear random.
Please help those that urinate on those they hate.
Please help.
Hold on. What exactly does that have to do with the maintenance of Veronica's chastity?
I think she peed in a tea.
Oh, God. Really?
Thank you.
just a word. Look how good she's being. Whoa. Amazing. Oh. This is slightly encouraging, Veronica. Don't stop. What are you doing?
I'm cleaning.
Down. Veronica, keep going. Keep cleaning up this mess that you made all by yourself. I saw everything. You do this all the time. Oh, sweetness. Seeing you down on your hands and knees like this puts me in the mind to do you a favor. Do you remember what we were talking about earlier today?
Am I going to get a spanking?
You don't remember, do you? You don't remember?
No.
Oh, my God. It's all right. We don't pay you to think. Oh, dear Plagueras, I will explain. You see, you might have recalled that the last time we were here, I had made a very serious, nearly deadly, fatal mistake. And that was that I allowed Veronica to play my harpsichord. You have to understand, nobody plays my harpsichord. However, it was a moment of weakness. I granted the request. I greatly regret it now. But here's the thing. 1 minute. This is the best thing about the turkey mic. Bitch. Not you. Here's the deal. Veronica has, in fact, been practicing the harpsichord somewhat diligently in the asylum tour bus. And we made a little bit of a deal. If Veronica can get through approximately half of our little display tonight with her chastity still intact, then she can have one more shot at playing the harpsichord for you. But you have to agree. So, assuming she's still a virgin, we will be checking that out later. May she have one more chance to not embarrass me and play the harpsichord. You're afraid of her. Really. I'm completely against the idea, so feel free. Are you quite sure?
Yeah.
I know you bribed them. Sexual favors?
Yeah.
Sarah, I have a question, Emily.
Mm-hmm.
If I do really, 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 really good on the harpsichord.
Which you won't. But if I did in a magical world,
can I please, please,
and
please.
I'm a fucking unicorn.
And I brought that unicorn.
Get on with it.
Can I please play the rat game?
Rat game!
I don't know. I'm not such a fan of this rat game you speak of. You don't say that at night on the tour bus. It's sort of thing you like to promote against young people. But, okay, how about this? If you can get through one single little piece here, and you make under, say, 3 mistakes, then you can play your little rat game.
Yes.
How about that? I know what happens, so we're really not going to hate you. Don't worry.
Yay.
Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Go, Veronica.
Up.
Veronica, come on.
So, stretch your fingers. I know they're not your primary tools. Show them everything I taught you.
Everything you taught me?
Almost everything. Veronica? Okay, focus. Stop flirting with me. Are you flirting with me?
Am I breathing?
You see what I have to live with.
You're so lucky.
Alright. Veronica! Focus! And go!
palm drawings.
Emily!
I hate that I have to wear gigantic platform shoes to be nearly as tall. Model bitches. You know what I'm saying. Done with the tea.
You're gonna pick up your hands and go like this. Rats, I can see you. Fuckers.
Pick up your hands.
Thank you.
Right, well, what did I tell you? What did I tell you about swearing on stage?
I'm sorry. Emily told me that if I curse on stage, which I hardly ever do because I am very pure, if I ever curse on stage, she said if I say indeed afterwards, it is much more civilized. So let's try that all again, okay, shall we? Because this is rock and roll, motherfucker!
Indeed!
So civilized and dirty. I knew I loved this crowd. It's just my type. All right, so we're gonna put our hands up. We're gonna go like this. We're gonna rasp, fucking indeed, like rasp. And then all of a sudden, we're gonna get close to each other. This is my new girlfriend and I. And then we're gonna go like this. Oh yes, I'm gonna love this. Alright, so we're gonna go
ratty, 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 ratty. Yeah!
Here's what's going to happen.
Repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Playgrounds, get down on the floor.
Playgrounds, get down on the floor.
5, 6, 7, 8.
5, 6, 7, 8.
We are at the fucking gate.
We are at the fucking gate.
Playgrounds.
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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
What is the new alive?
Yeah.
Damn.
I am in a very dangerous mood at this point. The adrenaline is too high. The thoughts are too violent. There's only one thing I can do to calm myself down. Tales of revenge. Bedtime stories. I'm going to tell you. Only if you're interested, of course. I'm thinking of telling you the story of the best revenge I've ever gotten. Interested?
Yeah.
It's quite simple, actually. Once upon a time, there was a house, and in the house, there was a wall, and in the wall, there was a room, but it was a very special room. And inside the room, there was... Let's just say, some things are immortal. Poems, books, a word of advice for anyone. Don't fuck with a songwriter.
You know that's a rap. You know that's a rap.
are you flirting with them?
Yes!
We flirt in different ways. She likes to serve tea, and I like to make out with people.
Okay, so don't come in for love. You're Thank you. bottom, nothing really matters to me.
Yeah.